Okay, it's your seventh year now in Bukovlje.
Yes.
Digging in Gradišće. Where are the main areas that you've been focusing on this year?
So since we are planning to conservate the church in 2 years, the first goal was to excavate around the apse, on the outer side of the apse, so that we can conservate it next year. And we were very interested in finding the towers. We assumed there are four for sure towers, maybe five. And this is why we opened this area that we assumed there is a one tower, and we excavated it. It's semicircular. It has a radius 3.3 meters. And it's built on the outer side of this defending wall of the fortress, and the wall is really astonishing.
This year is very, I should say, special for us, because at last we verified our assumptions about that part of the fortifications, especially about the outer wall and the tower. So this year we opened, I don't know, around 50 meters of the outer wall. So we defined that it is 2.2 meters wide, and the tower is somewhere about 3.5 meters diagonal. So it's quite impressive, and finally the people can see how it really looked and how it's impressive fortification, and that we were not crazy when we walked the wood and said, hey, here's the wall and here's the tower and so on. So it was a great find.
A little bit further on, in fact, just behind you, there is clear evidence of another tower.
There is another tower just beside me, and in future years it surely will be excavated also.
You've opened two sites primarily this year. What can you tell me about the tower site that you uncovered by the external?
So they did the inner rim, they did by machine before we were coming, the week before we were coming. It was this was an astonishing thing by itself. We're not accustomed to late antiquity walls standing 2 meters high. And the first thing was that we opened what is called Sonda 13 here on top, on the top of this wall, because there was expected a tower from the terrain. You could tell it from the terrain. We are sitting on the next tower, here. I could expect it from the terrain, and the sketch of the site, as in this official posters, the towers are indicated as rectangular. So we were quite astonished that it turned out to be a not rectangular, but then an angle like this. What looked triangular or polygonal. We of course were brainstorming about comparisons, mainly in Slovenia, because they are documented sites of this time. But it turned out that it is round inside, and we didn't find the outer rim of the tower. First, we didn't in the first days. We just looked for the outer rim of the wall, and which is 220 or 220 to 240. And the tower wall, there are long stones which put its teeth into the other wall. You know, they are linked together on the corner. So they are really built together. And on the inner rim of the wall, we saw two what looks like half arches. It was not a whole arch, so that we could postulate a gate or something like that. There is no gate, there is no window, there is no opening at all, no gap. It's also all one face, but there are some kind of arches, but only half arches. And it turned out to be that the triangle walls of the tower exactly lie in a line with these half arches, so this must be a technological speciality of building these military fortresses.
Thank you.
Now we are definitely those two, the one that we excavated, this beside me. We also suppose that there is another tower on the southeastern corner of the plateau. Probably it could be a gate tower.
Right, I was going to ask whether you've established where the end.
We are not yet sure. There are two possibilities based on analogies in Austria, Bosnia and Slovenia. One is between these two towers, and the second one is more probable, I think, on that narrow end of the plateau, mm-hmm. let's say so, because it is the most common place for the entrances is in fortifications like this. And on the other part of the site, we found some few phases of walls. At this point, we can define at least three phases of building. There are clearly some modifications during the period of that fortress existed, but at this point, we are not sure in interpretation of any of these finds. We'll see when the plans are made of this year excavation, so maybe it will be clearer. If not, we'll dig next year.
You found a rather curious weapon.
Yeah. Well, we suppose that here the life was also, the place was also occupied in the late Middle Ages, because we have found evidence of pottery from the 13th, 14th, 15th century. But this was a surprise, because we found this weapon that is made of iron, and it has a blade on one side, and it's like a peasant's weapon made for defending them from the horsemen. It's about 1 meter, and it's really, really interesting, yeah.
So the metal part would go into like a wooden stick?
Yeah.
Have you done many archaeological digs out of Austria?
No, that's my first experience.
Have you excavated any particular finds which are of special interest?
Yes, my most the find that I liked the most was the key that I found.
You found the key?
Yes, right. I found the key.
You also found a special piece of pottery, African red slipware.
Yes, but it was not mine. It was Anna's find, so.
Had you been digging another 30 seconds, you would have found
it. Yes, that's true. Yeah.
I think it was yesterday that you found a small piece of pottery which you told me was called red African slipware.
Yes.
Which part of Africa did that come from, and when does it date?
Generally, it's dated from beginning of 2nd century until 7th century. But in our part of Adriatic, it comes along with those imports of North African amphorae filled with olive oil. It dates from 4th century, late 4th century, and most common it's in first half of 5th century. The characteristic of this type of pottery is their decoration on the inner side, mm-hmm. and it corresponds to those on the oil lamps, ceramic oil lamps. Most common are concentric circles, floral and animal patterns.
Would this have been a bowl or a plate?
This piece that we found yesterday, it's been a bowl.
It was a bowl.
It was a bowl. It's dated in first half of the 5th century.
In the southwest corner, there is a very complicated kind of network of possible walls.
When we first unearthed it, and when I saw it, I only arrived yesterday in the morning, as I said, it looked really complicated. We just were, as Pedro always said, we were standing and staring, thinking and staring, and cleaning and staring and thinking. That's archaeology. We were up to four faces of walls in our discussions. Another big wall was because it stands on the debris of the late antiquity tower, so it must be later. And this broad wall leading to the edge of the cliff to the Mrežnica, this could be a proof of medieval reuse, maybe in this Turkish riots of the late 15th century, late 15th, early 16th century.
Now this year you've started publicizing the site.
Yes.
More. You've put up some panels by the entrance.
Yes. These are like information for the tourist and everyone who comes here can read a little bit of about this site and occupation from the prehistory till the Middle Ages. And I think it's a very good thing because people are asking for it and they, I think they do come here and visit. Yeah.
And the Ministry of Culture are behind you on this project?
Yes, it is actually. They are fully aware of the significance of this site and they give enough money to do some extra work on this conservation and everything. But also I must say that this Institute of Archaeology from Graz, they are also financing a part of excavation and conservation of the wall, which is great. I mean, we'll finish earlier.
Yeah. Well, hats off to you for organizing that.
It's
it's a great benefit.
Yeah.
Not just to Bukovlje, but to Croatia.
Yeah. I hope so.
Thank you very much.
Not at all.
Anna, this is your second year. How does this year compare to last year?
We have more time. Last year we only had 2 weeks and now we had the tower and in front of the apsis and now in the woods. So I think we had more cuts which we opened.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And yes, but it's nice to be here again.